Praise the Lord. Welcome to Okoy Church of God today for our homecoming, celebrating 61 years. Today is a special day for us and Grace Worship Center. 2 years ago, homecoming, 2 years ago is when you welcomed Grace Worship Center as a part of Okoy Church of God. So this is our second anniversary being a part of Okoy Church of God, and we want to thank you very much, your hospitality in the way that you welcomed us, and we thank you very much. Let's stand for the reading of your word, then we're going to have prayer and just go right into worship. My scripture reading today is 2 Chronicles chapter 5, verse number 11. And it came to pass, when the priests were come out of the holy place, for all the priests that were present were sanctified and did not even then wait by course. Also the Levites, which were the singers, all of them Asaph of Heman and Judith, with their sons and their brethren, being arrayed in white linen, having cymbals and psalteries and harps, stood at the east end of the altar, and with them 120 priests sounding the trumpets. It came to pass, as the trumpeters and singers were as one, to make one sound to be heard in praising and thanking the Lord, when they lifted up their voice with the trumpets and cymbals and instruments of music and praised the Lord, saying, "For he is good, for his mercy endureth forever," that then the house was filled with a cloud, even the house of the Lord, so that the priest could not stand to minister by reason of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord had filled the house of God. They just had finished dedicating the temple, setting it all up, brought the Ark of the Covenant in, and now they're singing. As they sing, it said they sang with one voice and one accord, and as they did, it said the house was filled with a cloud, even the house of the Lord, so that the priest could not stand to minister by reason of the house, for the glory of the Lord had filled the house of God. And then in chapter 7, when chapter 6, Solomon prays, and then chapter 7, as he begins, it says, "Now when Solomon had made an end of praying, the fire came down from heaven and consumed the burnt offerings and the sacrifices, and the glory of the Lord filled the house. And the priests could not enter the house of the Lord, because the glory of the Lord had filled the Lord's house. When all the children and Israel saw how the glory fire fell down and the glory of the Lord upon the house, they bowed themselves with their faces to the ground and upon the pavement and worshiped and praised God, praise the Lord, for he is good, his mercies endureth forever." This represents the Shekinah glory of God. As we celebrate homecoming today, this is what we want. We've been having 61 years of the power of Pentecost upon Okoy here, and now this year we're celebrating and we're inviting the Shekinah glory of God. Shekinah means dwelling. And that means the dwelling of God. And today, as we worship the Lord in one mind, in one accord, with one voice, with one instrument, all the instruments playing together in one unison, we're believing that the glory of the Lord, the Shekinah glory of God, just cover this place today, and the fire will fall, that we'll have to just praise and worship the Lord today. Let's do that right now. Worship the Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come in one mind and one accord this homecoming Sunday, Lord, inviting your divine presence, your Shekinah glory of God, to overshadow this place today. I pray today that you put the musicians and the singers and the instruments all in one mind and one accord, and all the worshipers, as we praise the Lord, let us to praise you for all the good things that you've done for Okoy Church of God, and let us just praise you and give you glory and give you honor and give you praise and give you honor. And Lord, as we do, we pray that you let that Shekinah glory of God to overshadow this place today, Lord. fall down among us today, Lord. Let that fire to fall, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Just open up blinded eyes, meet every need in every situation today. Let us not to leave this place the same today. So we worship you in one mind and one accord today. Lord, we just give you the praise and the glory and the honor, Lord. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Remain standing and let's worship the Lord in one accord today.
Who am I that you are mindful of me? That you hear me when I call.
Isn't it true that
you are thinking of me? Oh, how you love me. It's amazing. It's amazing. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. He calls me friend. Oh, I am a friend of God. Oh, I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. He calls me friend. Oh, who am I that you are mindful of me? That you hear me when I call. Is it true that you are thinking of me? Oh, how you love me. It's amazing. It's amazing. Oh, I am a friend of God. God, he calls me friend. Oh, I am a friend of God. Yes, I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. He calls me friend. God Almighty, Lord of glory, you have called me friend.
into our lives to call us a friend of God, the friend of the one who created this world, who created this universe, the one who died on the cross at Calvary for our sins. We can cry, worthy, worthy is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you paid, bearing all my sin and shame, and love you came and gave amazing grace. Thank you for this love, Lord. Wash me in your cleansing flow. Now all I know is your forgiveness and embrace.
Christ died on the cross for our sins. He had lived a spotless, unsinned, perfect life on this world. His life was holy. Now we can sing a holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, because he was sin-free. He was undirty. He was clean. And now we have the privilege to worship a perfect God, a holy God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is he. Sing a new song to him who sits on heaven's mercy seat. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
Clothed in rainbows of living color, flashes of lightning, rolls of thunder.
Blessing and honor, strength and glory and power be to you, the only wise King. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
I'm filled with wonder, awestruck wonder, just at the mention of your name.
Hallelujah. Jesus, your name is power, breath and living water, such a marvelous mystery. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
Is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is he.
Sing a new song to him who sits on heaven's mercy seat. Oh, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
Color, flashes of lightning, rolls of thunder.
Blessing and honor, strength and glory and power be to you, the only wise King. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
I'm filled with wonder, all struck wonder, just at the mention of your name.
Jesus, your name is power, breath and living water, such a marvelous mystery. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything.
Hallelujah. Oh, let's sing it one more time. Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
Oh, would you just lift up the name of Jesus in this place this morning? Father, truly you are the one we've come to praise and honor and to give glory to this morning. Lord, thank you for being our everything this morning. Thank you for the power of the Holy Ghost and the anointing of God. Thank you for the honey, God, that we can taste and see that it is good today. Thank you, Lord, that our eyes can be enlightened and our path can be lit as we walk this, Lord, walk this road, God, that you've called us to be on. Lord, thank you for being with us this morning. Lord, and we'll forever give you the praise, the honor, and the glory for it. In the name of Jesus, we pray this morning. And everybody said amen. And amen. You may be seated in the house of the Lord this morning. Look over at your neighbor and welcome them to homecoming. Amen. Welcome them to homecoming, our 61st homecoming celebration. And we're just excited about what God is doing and what God has already done these 61 years here as this church has proclaimed the power and the anointing of the Spirit of God. And lives have been touched, multiple lives, multiple ministries, multiple churches, multiple families have been moved upon by the power and the anointing of the Spirit of God. And I'm just glad I get to be a part of it today. Amen? Amen. If you don't know who I am Thomas Odom. I am the lead pastor. I have the privilege of serving this congregation the last 8 years as their lead pastor, and I can tell you I can stand on this platform this morning and testify to you that God has been faithful. Amen. Every battle, every mountain, every valley, every obstacle, God has been faithful. And we're going to celebrate some of that this morning. But before we get too far into that, I'm going to ask them if they'll go ahead and play our video this morning. If you'll focus your attentions to the screens, I would appreciate it this morning.
Someday, Liz, I'll go back, said Private First Class Peter Robert Zanetta of the 37th Engineer Combat Battalion and first assault wave to hit Omaha Beach. I'll go back and I'll see it all again. I'll see the beach, the barricades, and the graves. Those words of Private Zanetta come to us from his daughter, Lisa Zanetta Hinn, in a heart-rending story about the event her father spoke of so often. She tells some of his stories of World War II, but says of her father, the story to end all stories was D-Day. He made me feel the fear of being on that boat waiting to land. I can smell the ocean and feel the seasickness. I can see the looks on his fellow soldiers' faces, the fear, the anguish, the uncertainty of what lay ahead. And when they landed, I can feel the strength and courage of the men who took those first steps through the tide to what must have surely looked like instant death. And like all the families of those who went to war, she describes how she came to realize her own father's survival was a miracle. So many men died. I know that my father watched many of his friends be killed. I know that he must have died inside a little each time. Lisa Zanata Hen began her story by quoting her father who promised that he would return to Normandy. She ended with a promise to her father who died 8 years ago of cancer. I'm going there, Dad. And I'll see the beaches and the barricades and the monuments. I'll see the graves and I'll put flowers there just like you wanted to do. I'll feel all the things you made me feel through your stories and your eyes. I'll never forget what you went through, Dad, nor will I let anyone else forget. And Dad, I'll always be proud. Through the words of his loving daughter, who is here with us today, a D-Day veteran has shown us the meaning of this day far better than any president can. It is enough for us to say about Private Zanata and all the men of honor and courage, we will always remember. We will always be proud. We will always be prepared so we may be always free.
This week we will celebrate Veterans Day. And I know it's homecoming for us, but let's just be brutally honest. Because we live in the best country in the world, and these men and women that have served has allowed us the privilege and the freedom to be here today. I thought it would be appropriate that we took time on this Veterans Day week to remember those that have served. And I'm going to ask this morning if we have any veterans that are with us today in the house of the Lord, would you simply stand right where you're at and let us give honor and tribute to you this morning for what you have done and those that have went on before you. Can we let these know how much we love, appreciate them? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. They represent those and their families and the many, many others that have went on before them that have allowed us to gather in this place today to celebrate our freedom and to celebrate 61 years of ministry. And I did not want to go through this service and not pause and say thank you for your service to our nation. I still do believe it is the best nation in the world. Can somebody say amen for that today? Amen. It is good to have our associate pastor, Pastor Renfro, back home. They have been on a 9-day or so journey of the world, and they have traveled the highways, and they got home just after church started last night. To the surprise of them, their daughter and granddaughter and great-granddaughter was waiting for them at home, and I'm sure they're happy to see their daughter. I'm sure they're happy to see their granddaughter, but they're most happy of all to see that great-granddaughter. Amen. And we want to welcome them, and they're with us in service today as we celebrate homecoming and to be with Pastor and Sister Renfro. And he said, can I sit back here with my family today? I said, you can sit anywhere you want to. Amen. Who am I to tell him no? Amen. He's older than I am, but we're delighted that they're here and back. And good to have all of you with us today. In addition to Jacqueline's baby being with us, it's also a privilege to have Sister Sastra with us in the house of the Lord this morning. She is no stranger to this family. Health has not allowed her to be in service much the last several years. And I was by to see her. I think Pastor Dustin was with me when I went the last time. And we were talking about all kind of things. And she says, as we were wrapping up our conversation, she said, I'm planning to be at homecoming in just a few weeks. I said, you are? She says, that is my plan. I've been gearing up, been asking Rebecca and Myra. I said, is she still planning on coming? She is. And I was delighted to look back this morning and see that she is in the church that she calls home, and she is part of our family. Sister Sastra, we love you, and we are delighted that you are here with us this morning. Would you one more time give the Lord a hand clap of praise for His faithfulness? Amen. By way of announcements, if you'll grab your bulletins, you'll need them in just a moment, but there'll be no service here tonight. We moved our Sunday night service to last night. Had a wonderful time in the Lord last night. So you get the night off. Let me encourage you, if there's a good church close to where you live, maybe go and just surprise them tonight. Fellowship with them. Don't move to them. Just go fellowship and visit them and be back here on Wednesday night. We'll be back in a full service mode on Wednesday night, but no service tonight. And then there's a lot of events leading up to this week, so make sure you grab your bulletin. I do want to bring your attention to our David Holly Memorial Thanksgiving dinners. If you can help us with those, we're raising money for that. We're giving them out to our community. And let me just say, as your pastor, if you need a Thanksgiving dinner, listen carefully to me. The reason this church has been here 61 years, I believe part of it is because every time there's been a need presented, as long as I've been here, this church has responded. This is your church, and we are your family. And if you are a part of this church or your family connected with this church, and you have a need and you could use a Thanksgiving dinner, can I encourage you not to worry about having to write your name on a piece of paper, but do that this morning. Drop it in that offering plate. Call the office. Talk to Miss Christy. Let her know, hey, Christy, I really could use the Thanksgiving. We want to bless you. It is not something that we're doing begrudgingly. It's not something that we want to do trying to find the money for. No, the money is there. You have responded. Money has been given, and we want to bless families in our community. And if you could use the Thanksgiving dinner, please let us know of that. And speaking of that, maybe in your bulletin where it announces the Thanksgiving dinner, possibly yours is highlighted in yellow. Anybody's highlighted in yellow? One of them right there and one of them right there. A brother and a sister got this morning. How in the world did we ever figure that out? Brother Gene and Sister Mandy, y'all got to come get these. Amen. If you don't come get them, I'm using them to feed the preacher. Preacher, this is all the money I had for lunch today, so we might have to Daniel's fast today. Amen. Hallelujah. But we do that. Thank you. Use them wisely, and let's give them one more hand. Always a fun time, and we want to just give back to our church and back to our community and back to our home folks. And y'all should take Don and Joyce out for lunch today, and they would appreciate that and spend that money on them this morning. I'm going to ask the ushers, if they would, to get ready to wait upon you, give you an opportunity this morning to give your homecoming offering. I mean, when we think about what God's done the last 61 years, I have only been a part of this church for about the last 15 years, about 25% of those 61 years. But I can tell you without a doubt, God has been faithful and true. And I'm glad today that we have a church in Ocoee that still believes in saved, being saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. And there is a right way of living. And I want to raise my kids, and God ever allows me to have grandkids, I want to raise my grandkids in a way that is right, and I'm thankful. And I hope you are proud, not proud to be prideful, but proud to be humbling, that says, God, I am thankful today that we have a church that we can go to every week, Sunday morning, Sunday night, and Wednesday night, and lift up the name of Jesus. And part of that is worshiping in our giving. And today we're going to do that through our tithes and through our offerings. It is the first Sunday of the month, and I need you to be faithful. Let's do what God's called us to do. When we get everything done, we know that God will be pleased with it. The ushers will serve you from the rear of the building, and when they get to the front of the altar area, we'll ask for God's blessings. God bless you as you give this morning. Let us pray this morning. Father, we thank you for the privilege we've had to give of our tithes and of our offerings to the storehouse. Pray, God, that you'll bless and multiply it for its intended use. Bless every family represented here this morning. Just pray that you'll move in their home and in their finances and in their family, Lord, in their jobs and their situations, and we'll forever be grateful for it. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And everybody said, amen. And amen. Thank you again for your giving this morning. Brother Roger's coming to lead us. I wanted to do a congregational last night and a congregational this morning. Would you stand with us this morning? And let's just have one big open choir and let's sing one of those songs out of that red back book.
Page 212 is Keep on the Firing Line. Now, I had no idea this was Veterans Day week when I chose this song last week. But the Holy Spirit knew. Did you know that we as Christians are facing a D-Day? Desperate day. Tuesday coming is a desperate day of decision for this nation. We need to be on our knees, but not still. There's a lot of those soldiers we just saw pictures of that were on their knees, but they didn't stay in one place. They were crawling and crawling forward, not backwards. We're going to have to be busy, folks. We are God's army, and we need to be busy about His work. And that's why the nation is in the trouble it's in, because we haven't been. But we need to turn around. And listen to the words of this song as we sing. If you're in the battle for the Lord and right, and if you're not, you should be. Amen, we should be. So let's sing this old song, but it's still true. Keep on the firing line. We got to keep on it. If you're in the battle for the Lord and right, keep on the firing line. If you win, my brother, surely you must fight. Keep on the firing line.
Dangerous.
We all must face. If we die of fighting, it is no disgrace. Coward in the service, he will find no place. So keep on the firing line, where you must fight. Be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line, where you must fight. Be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line. Well, listen to this. God will only use a soldier he can trust. Keep on the firing line. If you wear a crown, then bear a cross you must. Keep on the firing line. Labor for the master dear. Help to banish evil and to spread good cheer. Great you'll be rewarded for your service here. So keep on the firing line, where you must fight. Be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God in the right, just keep on the fire. Sing that second verse again. God will only use a soldier he can trust. Keep on the firing line. If you wear a crown, then bear a cross you must. Keep on the firing line. Life is but to labor for the master dear. Help to banish evil and to spread good cheer. Great you'll be rewarded for your service here. So keep on the firing line, where you must fight. Be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, us to keep on the firing line. Oh, when we get to heaven, brother, we'll be glad to keep on the firing line. How we'll praise the Savior for the call we had. Keep on the firing line. When we see the souls that we have helped to win, leading them to Jesus from the paths of sin, with a shout of welcome we will all march in. So keep on the firing line, where you must fight, be brave against all evil, and never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line. If you're in the battle for the Lord and right, keep on the firing line. If you win, my brother, surely you must fight. Keep on the firing line. There are many dangers that we all must face. If we die fighting, it is no disgrace. Coward in the service, he will find no place. So keep on the firing line. Well, you must fight, be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line. Well, you must fight, be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line.
Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated in the house of the Lord this morning. Every year during homecoming, we try to highlight a few pictures of just the last year, since homecoming last year. And we've tried to do that again today. And if you'll focus your attentions to the screens one more time this morning, they have a homecoming slideshow they want to present to you. And some of it we'll cry over, some of it we'll laugh over. But let's enjoy it together. Pastor Dustin.
Thank you.
Amen. Truly, God has been good to us again this year. Amen. The many ministry and outreach events that we have had, and I'm thankful to be a part of that. I want to make a presentation this morning, and this family is not aware, to my knowledge, that I will be making this presentation. But I'm going to ask, and Pastor Ricky, you may need to help me. I'm going to ask Brother Rex if he'll come and join me here in the main altar area. Every year for the last several years, we have taken time to present to the family of church members of the Church of God that have passed away since the last homecoming. And there are many families that have lost loved ones even this year since homecoming last year. But for the last several years, we've taken time to present to those family members of members, Church of God members, just a plaque of our recognition of their faithfulness. And I want to do that again this morning to Brother Rex. Sister Wendy, if you'll come join me on the main floor. And, just a few months ago, we said goodbye to Sister Pat. And she's made it to where we're headed to. And if things go as planned, in just a few days, Brother Rex will be going to northern Michigan to spend several weeks with Kevin and Tina, his son and daughter-in-law there in northern Michigan. And I heard of that, and you may remember I asked you a few weeks ago, I said, now you're going to be here for homecoming, right? That's why I was trying to figure out, make sure his schedule was going to work. And if not, I would have to call Kevin and get it changed. I have a plaque that I want to give. I'm going to read it to you. It says, presented to the family of Patricia Rushing, in recognition of your loved one's faithful commitment to the kingdom of God, presented this 6th day of November in the year of our Lord 2016, 61st homecoming celebration, Ocoee Church of God, lead pastor, Bishop Thomas Odelman. I want you to know, as we celebrate homecoming, not only as an organ player, not only as a faithful member, her mother and father pastored here, and she was your sweetheart for 50 plus years. And we want to take time in this homecoming service to say thank you for sharing her with our church for all those years. And can we just let Brother Rex know how much we love him this morning? See her again soon, and today would be okay with me. Amen. Amen. Would you let Brother Rex know how much you love him this morning? Hallelujah. As I was looking over our files preparing for homecoming, and those I don't like going to those files, Brother Jarman. I don't like those files I have to look at, and because it reminds me of loved ones that we've lost as we have been a part of your family and a part of your life, and we've said goodbye to others. And but Sister Pat was a member of our church, an official member of the Church of God, and we wanted to recognize her this morning. Just before the youth choir comes, how do you transition after that? Amen? Just before the youth choir comes, let me say, as you're praying, I ask that you also remember the Baker family. Sister Effie Mae's husband, Terry, went on to be with the Lord earlier this week. Services were yesterday. We were also notified late last night. You don't see Brother Steve Johnson here. Steve Johnson's wife, Debbie, she's been with her mother for several weeks, and her mother passed away late last night. So that's where they're at today. So I just ask that you remember, and that's part of what a family is. We celebrate together, we mourn together, we cry together, we laugh together, and sometimes we do all of that in the same setting. So as we're celebrating today, and remembering today, let us also pray for these families that have had lost loved ones just in the last couple of days, that God will strengthen them and comfort them as well. And Brother Jarman, thank you for being with us again this weekend. Didn't he preach to us last night? Amen. I don't know if it's cat head or fat head biscuits. It's cat head is what I was told. I think he called him fathead and then corrected it later. He must have been hungry, but he didn't eat after church last night. We talked about honey. We talked about cathead biscuits. We talked about all kind of things. Amen. And so we want to say thank you again for being with us. And you were with us 2 years ago when Grace Worship Center joined us. And our bishop was here, and we want to say thank you for coming back. And will you let Brother Jarman know how much you're delighted to have him with us again today? He and his wife, they make their home there in Mississippi, have an older daughter and a younger daughter. Their younger daughter turned 12 just a few days ago. He was away on her birthday, and my baby turns 11 tomorrow. I will be away for her birthday. It's hard sometimes when your babies are growing up, but I want to say thank you, Brother Jarman, for spending the extra weekend with us in Florida. And he'll be coming to minister to you right after the youth choir this morning. Hatton, our youth choir, just done a wonderful job as they have matured and grown. And youth choir, come on up at this time. They're going to minister to you in song. And then after the youth choir sings, when they get done, whatever God has for them and has for us, after they get done, the next voice that we're scheduled to hear on this platform will be Brother Jarman. Let's get in. Let's worship the Lord together this morning.
Tired of the devil's games, keeping me in bondage to my sorrows and shames. I deserve better, won't go another day. I'm here to claim deliverance in Jesus' name. I feel the joy of the Lord calling, fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me.
Well, I feel the joy of the Lord calling, fresh on me. Through these veins, child of the King, buried in His name. There is no devil that can come against me. You see, I have been bought, I've been set free. I feel the joy of the Lord calling.
Holy Ghost all over me.
If I could sing, you'd be in trouble. I can tell you that. I'm telling you right now. I just feel this in my soul, right? Amen. Feel the joy of the Lord. Amen. Titus, can you sing that by yourself? Come on back one more time. Amen. I just want to have church this morning. I just want to let God have his way. What about it? Amen. I want you to put your hands together. If you feel God in this house, amen, I'm telling you, it's normal. But if you can't feel it, I'm worried about you. Amen. Come on.
Now I'm a little tired of the devil's games, keeping me in bondage through my sorrows and shames. I deserve better, won't go another day. I'm here to claim deliverance in Jesus' name. I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Now I have royal blood flowing through these veins. Child of the King, been buried in his name. There is no devil that can come against me. I have been bought, I've been set free. I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Well, you see, I have been loose, I've been set free. Pardon me a moment while I have a jubilee. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Well, I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Well, I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Well, I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me.
Give the Lord a hand clap of praise, will you? Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. My. Thank you, Jesus. You may be seated. You may be seated if you can. If you can't, stand up. Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise him. Glory to God, glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Holy Ghost, have your way.
Thank you.
Come on, folks, let's worship him. The Holy Ghost has come by this morning. He wants to bless your life. He wants to bless your life today. Come on.
I'm a little tired of the devil's games, keeping me a bondage through my sorrows and shames. I deserve better, won't go another day. I'm here to claim deliverance in Jesus' name. I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Now I have royal blood flowing through these veins. Child of the King, been buried in his name. There is no devil that can come against me. You see, I have been bought, I've been set free. I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Now I have royal blood flowing through these veins. Child of the King, been buried in his name. There is no devil that can come against me. You see, I have been bought, I've been set free. I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Well, you see, I have been loose, I've been set free. Pardon me a moment while I have a jubilee. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Well, I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me. Well, I feel the joy of the Lord falling fresh on me. I feel the joy of the Lord delivering me. I feel the joy of the Holy Ghost all over me.
Oh, hallelujah. Ah, my, my, my. Glory to God. Oh, isn't it good to feel His presence? I said, isn't it good to feel His presence? Oh, when the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords shows up and there's something wrong in your life, He can make it right. Say amen, somebody. Oh, when you feel the joy of the Lord all over you, oh, you can lift your hands. You can praise Him. It's because of Him that we move and breathe and have our being today. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, yes. You go ahead. Get all you want this morning. He's bowed the heavens low. He's riding on the wings of praise in this house. Hallelujah. If you feel Him, raise your hands. Come on. If you feel His presence, begin to magnify Him. Glory. Shalabahatai. My God, I feel His presence in this. Praise Him. Praise Him, somebody. You know, this is the quietest place that you'll ever be when you get close to God. When we get over yonder, the Bible said the 24 elders cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. here, you might as well praise him. You might as well get what you came for. Hey! I can't give it to you. Pastor can't give it to you. The person standing beside you can't give it to you. But the one that gives you breath, he deserves the glory. He deserves the honor. It's up to you. I said, it's up to you. If there was anything wrong in my life, amen, I believe I tried my best to get it fixed before I left the presence of God. Say amen. My God in heaven. Amen. If you've got a need in your life, I want you to know the need meter is here. If you've got circumstance in your life that you don't understand, come by tonight to reveal, or this morning to reveal it to you. Maybe your back's against the wall. You're fighting every imp, every minion of hell. But today's come by to give you victory. Come on, somebody. Victory belongs to the child of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you're here and there's something that you want God to do for you, I want you to get out right now from where you're standing and make your way to the front. If nobody moves, we're going to preach. But if you move, we're going to have church right on. Say amen. You may say, what are they going to think about it? What are they going to do, Brother Jarman? It ain't their business. It's between you and God. Come on here. Now these are the only ones. I see some distant looks in your eyes this morning. You need God to help you. You need God to stir something up in you. This is your privilege. This is your opportunity. Hallelujah. I need some folks to join me in these altars. If you believe that God is able to meet these needs, find you somebody to back behind. Lay your hands on them and let's get on to God. Church, come on. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, God, lay your hands on these children of yours in the mighty name of Jesus. Pray, church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pray, church. Great God, I feel the Holy Ghost. Real Abbasada Bahatai. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. God, I believe you. Come on, church. Come on, church. Holy Ghost, have your way. In the name of Jesus. Raven, sister, come on here. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. God, by your power. God, by your spirit. Come on, church. Let him have his way. Lay your hands on somebody. Let's get on to God.
Well, I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm
yes!
not coming down.
Oh, God's here today.
If
you feel him, you come. If you feel him, you come.
I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall.
In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost power, roll.
Tell the devil drop by. The heaven talk with me. Come on down to rest your feet. Well, I didn't even come. Take the time to turn around. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down. I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall, I won't come down.
The devil looking on, they shake their head and say that wall's way too high. You don't have to live that way. My answer's still the same and it will never ever change.
I'm building on this wall, I won't come down. Well, I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down.
Praise him, church.
Well, the devil.
Praise him for what he's
just
doing.
To have a little talk with me. Said you're working way too hard. Come on down and rest your feet. Well, I didn't even stop. Take the time to turn around. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down. Well, I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down.
Well, I'm building on this
wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down. I'm building on this wall and I won't come down.
Come on, church!
Looking on, they shake their head and say that wall's way too high. You don't have to live that way.
My answer's still the same. It will never, ever change.
I'm building on this wall and I won't come down.
Well, I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down.
I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down.
I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down.
I'm building on this wall and I won't come down.
Well, I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down.
I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down.
I'm building on this wall and I'm not coming down.
I'm building on this wall and I won't come down.
Come on, church.
You know not the day.
Don't keep your mind on the Lord.
Lord shall call your soul away. If you're fighting, striving for the right, you shall wear a robe and crown.
Well, I'm going to wear a crown.
I'm going to wear a crown.
When that trumpet sounds.
When the trumpet sounds.
Oh, I'm going to wear a crown.
I'm going to wear a crown.
Soon at my feet strike.
Zion.
Lay down my heavy
burden.
Put on my robe and
glory.
Shout and tell the glad
story.
We shall wear a robe and crown. Well, I'm going to wear a crown. When that trumpet sounds.
When that trumpet sounds.
Oh, I'm gonna wear a crown.
I'm gonna wear a crown.
Soon at my feet strike
Zion.
Lay down my heavy
burden.
Put on my robe and
glory.
Shout and tell the glad
story.
We shall wear a robe and crown. Watch ye therefore, you know not the day.
Listen, I just want to obey God. Is that all right? I feel like there's somebody else in this room. You've been in a hard place of lately. And you're saying, if I could just only get to God. And I want the Lord to lay his hand on me. Maybe it's been a long time since you felt the Holy Ghost. But you know what you're feeling right now. And you know that it's him. And you say, I just really want the church to pray for me. If that's you, I want you to come and stand right here. We're going to pray for you. I just can't help but feel this. Three times I felt the Holy Ghost nudge me and say, just open it up for anybody that wants special prayer. If you're here right now and we're fixing to sing this again, and I don't know which way it's going to go, but this is your chance. You've talked to God maybe in private, maybe just alone driving down the road, and you said, if the Lord would just come by and meet this need, I know that everything is going to be all right. And the devil said, no, don't go up there. But I promise you this morning, if you will come right now, I believe God's going to meet your need. But it's up to you. You got to get up and come. He said, obedient. I could touch you on the nose right now. I know exactly who you are. I could walk down and touch you, but I'm not going to do that. This is up to you. God's come by for somebody. He interrupts the program for a reason. I want you to get up right now in the name of Jesus. Brother Ronnie, I got to have it. Open it up so our sister can come. We're going to stand right here. She's not by herself. There's somebody else. You know, I'd feel so much better if I knew that I came to church and Jesus stopped the service just for me. That he stopped it, that I could get what I needed. Sir, ma'am, whatever you're facing, I believe it'll all go away when you come up here, step out by faith. Come on. Pray, church, in the name of Jesus. Will you come? She's not by herself. There's somebody else. Come on, ladies, let's lay our hands on her. Let's believe God. Come on, let's worship the King.
I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley, though I drink through the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my
find you somebody to pray for. Lay your hands on your neighbor.
Well, I got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink through the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I put my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley, though I drink through the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking,
show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I put my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
Well, I got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley, though I drink through the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking,
showing me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I put my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
I started out to win this race, to serve the Lord and to look upon his face. But the way's been long and the way's been rough. But there's one thing for sure, I've got my mind made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley, though I drink through the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way.
I stand right square on my feet, I put my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. Well, I got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley, though I drink through the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I put my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
Well, I started out to win this race, to serve the Lord and to look upon his face. But the way's been long and the way's been rough. But there's one thing for sure, I've got my mind made up.
I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I put my head in the air, I say, straight in the eye, I say, my
foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
The devil will tempt you and fill your way with strife. He'll make you sick in body and even try to take your life. But put your trust in Jesus and say, Lord, I've had enough. The Lord will say, move on, Satan, he's got his mind made up.
Well, I got my
foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink through the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, showing me an easier way,
I stand right square on my feet. I put my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my
foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
Well, I got my
foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, showing me an easier way,
I stand right square on my feet. I put my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my
foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
I've got my
foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, showing me an easier way.
Square on my feet, I throw my head in the air.
I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
Now Job was a man who was tempted in every way. The devil took his family, lay sick both night and day. His wife's kept saying, God curse your God and die. He said, you talk like a foolish woman, I've got my mind made up.
Well, I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet. I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, show me an easier way.
I stand right
square on my feet. I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
I got my
foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, show me an easier way. Square on my feet, I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
Well, I started out to win this race, to serve the Lord and to look upon his face. But the way's been long and the way's been rough. But there's one thing for sure, I've got my mind made up.
I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet. I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet. I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I
when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
Well, let's sing it again this morning. I've got my
foot on the rock and my mind's made up.
Though I walk
through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I started out to win this race, to serve the Lord and to look upon his face. But the way's been long and the way's been rough. But there's one thing for sure, I've got my mind made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. The devil will tempt you and fill your way with strife. He'll make you sick in body and even try to take your life. But put your trust in Jesus and say, Lord, I've had enough. The Lord will say, move on, Satan, he's got his mind made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way.
I stand right
square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right square on my feet, I throw my head in the air, I look him straight in the eye, I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
Oh, if you know this one, sing it one time with them this morning. Amen. I've got my
foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup,
When the devil comes a-knocking, show me an easier way.
I stand right, square on my feet.
I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
We'll give the Lord a hand clap of praise for that in this house this morning. Do you feel like you've been to church this morning? Amen. Do you feel like we have celebrated the faithfulness of God? Amen. And has he not showed up to show us that he is always an on-time God? Amen. One more time, give the Lord a hand clap of praise around this place. I've got my...
Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right, square on my feet. I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up. I've got my foot on the rock and my mind's made up. Though I walk through the lonely valley and I drink from the bitter cup, when the devil comes a-knocking, show me an easier way. I stand right, square on my feet. I throw my head in the air. I look him straight in the eye. I say my foot's on the rock and my mind's made up.
One more time, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. Jesus tarries, and I pray he don't, but if he tarries, and there's 61 more years, I believe the same Spirit of God that touched us 61 years ago, the same Spirit of God that touched us today, is faithful enough, Brother Walcott, to carry us all the way to the end. And I wouldn't trade it for nothing, Pastor Jeff. Why? Because I am absolutely nothing without his touch. And when it's God's plan and God's desire and God's vision and God's will, it will happen. And whatever God wants is what I want. Amen. Would you stand with me this morning? You preached a mighty fine message this morning, preacher. Hallelujah. That's probably the best one I've heard him preach since I met him in 1999. Hallelujah. I did see his title laying right there. It's a good one. But the Holy Ghost preached the better one. Amen. Wow. Are you glad you're part of the family of God? I am. I'm glad you're part of the family of God right here at Ocoee. Before we dismiss, let me just say a thank you to everyone that has helped make homecoming what it was, the prep leading up. This stuff just don't happen. You don't just show up and it's ready. There's a lot of prep that happens behind the scenes, weeks and weeks in advance. And I do want to say thank you to everyone, workday, setup crew, teardown crew, cleanup crew, everybody. I do want to say a special thanks to my wife. She puts up with me 24 hours a day, and that can be difficult sometimes. I know that. And new to us this year, I do want to take time and say thank you to my admin, Sister Christy. She's probably already back at the Welcome Center, but this is her first homecoming event that she's had to deal with Pastor on in the office. And again, I'm not the easiest person to deal with sometimes. And as that pencil gets tight and that vice gets tight, I want it right for homecoming. Amen. And Sister Rebecca's transitioned to a new role this year, and we did have to pull some of her over. I say, make sure that I told her that right. Make sure I didn't tell her wrong. I don't know how to do that. Go fix it. And but I do want to say for Sister Christy, thank you. She helps us a whole lot, and we're thankful for all that God's doing. Teachers and van drivers and kitchen folks. I mean, what a wonderful church to be a part of. Amen. If I wasn't the pastor of this church and didn't have a ministry assignment, I'd want to come to church here. Amen. I did before I was a preacher. You remember that? Before I was your pastor, I attended here. It's a good church. And I want it to be better because of Jesus, not because of us. Thank you for being with us tonight. Take the night off. Go home and watch a Hallmark Christmas movie or something. And be praying. Staff is leaving this afternoon. We have to be in St. Petersburg for an 8 o'clock session in the morning. So about 15 of us are leaving this afternoon. Be praying for our travel and mercy that God will be with us there. Be with us tomorrow. Be back with us tomorrow night. And then we'll be back in the offices on Monday for a full day of ministry and school. God bless you. Brother Jarman will meet you in the foyer. Let him know how much you loved him. And we'll see you Wednesday night for church. You are dismissed.